So we have a circle here, and they specified some points for us. This little orangish, or I guess maroonish red point right over here is the circle, is the center of the circle, and then this blue point is a point that happens to sit on the circle. And so with that information, I want you to pause the video and see if you can figure out the equation for this circle. All right, let's work through this together. So let's first think about the center of the circle. And the center of the circle is just going to be the coordinates of that point. So the x coordinate is -1, and then the y coordinate is 1. So center is -1, 1. And now let's think about what the radius of the circle is. Well, the radius is going to be the distance between the center and any point on the circle. So for example, this distance, the distance of that line, let's see, I could do a thicker version of that. This line right over there, something strange about my pen tool is making that very thin. Let me do it one more time. Okay, that's better. The distance of that line right over there, that is going to be the radius. So how can we figure that out? Well, we can set up a right triangle and essentially use the distance formula, which comes from the Pythagorean theorem. To figure out the length of that line, so this is the radius, we could figure out a change in x. So if we look at our change in x right over here, our change in x as we go from the center to this point, so this is our change in x, and then we could say that this is our change in y. That right over there is our change in y. And so our change in x squared plus our change in y squared is going to be our radius squared. That comes straight out of the Pythagorean theorem. This is a right triangle. And so we can say that r squared is going to be equal to our change in x squared plus our change in y squared. Plus our change in y squared. Now what is our change in x squared, or what is our change in x going to be? Our change in x is going to be equal to, well, when we go from the radius to this point over here, our x goes from -1 to 6. So you can view it as our ending x minus our starting x. So -6 minus -1 is equal to 7. So we have our change in x, this right over here, is equal to 7. If we viewed this as the start point and this as the end point, it would be -7, but we really care about the absolute value of the change in x, and once you square it, it all becomes a positive anyway. So our change in x right over here is going to be +7. And our change in y, well, we are starting at y is equal to 1, and we are going to y is equal to -4. So it would be -4 minus 1, which is equal to -5. And so our change in y is -5. You could view this distance right over here as the absolute value of our change in y, which of course would be the absolute value of 5. But once you square it, it doesn't matter. The negative sign goes away. And so this is going to simplify to 7 squared. Change in x squared is 49. Change in y squared, -5 squared is 25. So we get r squared is equal to 49 plus 25. So what's 49 plus 25? Let's see, that's going to be 54. Was it 74? R squared is equal to 74. Did I do that right? Yep, 74. And so now we can write the equation for the circle. The circle is going to be all of the points that are, well, and let me write the, so if r squared is equal to 74, r is equal to the square root of 74. And so the equation of the circle is going to be all points x, y that are this far away from the center. And so what are those points going to be? Well, the distance is going to be x minus the x coordinate of the center, x minus -1 squared. Let me do that in blue color. -1 squared plus y minus the y coordinate of the center, y minus 1 squared is going to be equal to r squared, is going to be equal to the length of the radius squared. Well, r squared, we already know, is going to be 74. And then if we want to simplify a little bit, you subtract a negative, this becomes a positive. So it simplifies to x plus 1 squared plus y minus 1 squared is equal to 74. And we are all done.